What is going on, everybody? It is Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. Today we are talking about how to go ahead and upgrade your iPhone, your iPad to the public beta of iOS and iPadOS 14. Let's get started. If you are installing beta software on your phone for the first time, you want to make sure that there's nothing that's mission critical on your device that you need in order to go ahead and have it function for whatever you're doing. If something breaks, you're going to have to roll back. So make sure that you can understand what is going on. Now, the first thing I'm going to tell you to do is go ahead and do a backup using Finder. Now, if you're not on a Mac, if you're on a PC, I'll go ahead and put the instructions in the comments below. Let's go ahead and connect our device to our Mac. Now you're gonna get prompted for two different things on your phone. So first, when you connect your phone to your Mac, you wanna make sure that your iPhone trusts this device. You're gonna go ahead and enter in your password on your iPhone. Then once you go ahead and select it to go ahead and perform a encrypted backup, you're gonna go ahead and enter in your password again on your device a second time. Make sure you choose a secure password. Now you see here along the bottom, we're actually going ahead and we're backing up the data. Now here we see that this backup is encrypted. If we want to go ahead and change the password now, we're going to go ahead and click backup now. So depending on how much data that you have on your phone, it's going to take a number of minutes. Once the backup is done, it's going to show the last time it was backed up to iCloud, in addition to showing when the last time it was backed up to the local machine. Now that the most recent backup for your device is complete, we see here the last backup done to this Mac shows the time and date that it's been completed. We're gonna go ahead and archive that backup. So let's go to click on Manage Backups. So when you do an archive backup, what that does is it's gonna take a snapshot of your device and it's gonna go ahead and save it so that archive cannot be overwritten by the next time that you do a backup. Here we see the backup. We're gonna go ahead and right click on that. We're gonna click on Archive and it shows the locked icon along with today's time and date that it was done. Let's go ahead and click OK. So now we have the most recent image of our device backed up and locked and archived. So in case anything goes wrong, which, hey, you know what? It's a beta. It certainly could happen. We can always roll back to it. Next step is going to be to install the device profile on our device. And go ahead and do so. We're going to go to beta.apple.com/profile. From our mobile device, we're going to go ahead and click install. It's going to go ahead and download that profile to our device. And once that's installed, we're gonna need to go to settings, tap on profile, and then follow the on-screen instructions to allow the installation of that profile. To download the software update, you'll need to be connected to Wi-Fi, and then to install it, you'll need to either be connected to power if you have less than 50% battery or have more than 50% battery. With iOS and iPadOS 14 in developer preview, I've got a number of different apps planned in addition to my full review of those apps, so make sure you are subscribed with notifications to be alerted when that content drops. Now, in case you're looking for a video to how to go ahead and downgrade your device, I'll have that linked in the video description below. I am Mike, this is Tech 24/7 TV. I'll talk to you in the next one.